You know, I think one of my favorite bad guys is Envy.
Envy!
And I think mostly because Envy is such a tragic character. You spend the whole series going, oh my gosh, Envy is the worst, baddest, meanest, no redeeming qualities, angry, hateful, vengeful, right? And then you find out why. And then toward the end of the series, you find out what happened that drove this character to be so full of hate and vengeance. And you kind of get it. Kind of like, oh my gosh, you know? I can understand why this character hates Ed and Al so much.
Loathe.
Being abandoned as they were. Sorry, I hope I didn't just give anything away, but... Oops. Yes, in the back. Yes. Love that. I think it would be the most awesome movie, don't you? If they made a live-action Full Metal Alchemist? Woo! Holy crap. Woo! That would be sweet. Yeah. Okay, I would be like playing Ed's grandfather. Or maybe I could play Hohenheim.
Hohenheim!
Yeah, I mean, but clearly I wouldn't be playing Ed. I'm way too tall. I think that would be awesome. And the only thing that I would say is I would hope and pray that it would be done by an independent company, because if Hollywood gets a hold of it, they'll ruin it like they do everything else. I mean, don't even get me started. I am so... You know what? I was talking to my girlfriend the other day, and I said, you know what we ought to do? Wouldn't it be cool if we could organize, like, in a viral way, like grassroots through the internet, organize 1 week where we get everybody not to go to a movie. Just as a way of saying, I'm so sick of you making the same crap over and over again. I'm so sick of you guys making hundreds of millions of dollars doing old TV shows over and over again, or old movies that everybody loved, making them again. I mean, come up with an original idea for crying out loud, you know?
Yeah.
And you're so sick of it. And some of them, the scripts are so insulting. You know, and they just completely rely on special effects and stuff. I just would love... The problem is that they know that we love movies. How many people do you know, and maybe yourself, you say to your girl or your guy, hey, let's go see a movie tonight. So you go to the movies, and you walk up and go, all right, what do you want to see? There may not even be anything good, and you'll pick some crap just because... You wanted to see a movie, and you'll give them your $30, and it doesn't even matter if it was any good. They got your money. That's all they care, because they know people love movies, and that's why they completely dropped the bar to making great movies. Some of the greatest movies now are like animated films, like Up and
Wall.
Those are beautiful stories. They're great, creative stories.
Wow.
Why is it that people like Pixar can come up with these amazingly creative stories, meanwhile, stinking movie companies are making Hulk 3. I mean, wasn't the first one bad enough, you know?
It was awful.
I mean, how big a bath do you need to take on a movie before you think, we shouldn't make another one of those? You know? And they just rehash the same things over and over again. And I get so angry seeing them make great classic movies again. Like, leave it the hell alone. I was walking down the hallway the other day and saw a marquee poster. They're remaking Fame.
No!
You know that movie?
No.
That was a brilliant movie. You can't make that movie anymore.
No!
It was an 80s movie about a period in time and the Juilliard School and everything, and it was so indicative of the time. You don't make that movie again, but they're going to do it. And they're going to make Land of the Lost, and they make this, and then... They're making tens of millions of dollars with no new ideas. Because Hollywood's being run by lawyers, not creatives. And you know what the worst thing is? I guarantee you, there is a pile 5 feet high of scripts of amazing stories. And nobody's got the guts to make one. They just keep cranking out the formula junk that you could literally replace the names and it's the same movie that you've seen 15 times. Because they don't want to take a chance. You know who takes the chances? The independent companies. And look at what the greatest films lately have been. They've been from independent companies. Slumdog Millionaire.
Woo!
Amazing film.
Yes.
What in Hollywood? Little Miss Sunshine. Amazing film. What in Hollywood? It's, you know what I'm saying? They miss out on, you know, all these great ideas because they're afraid to do anything different. So I would love to organize something like that. I don't even know how we would do it, but it would be great for people to take back, you know, to say, you know, you're going to take our money. We should have some say in the kind of stuff you make. That's just me. Sorry, I get off my soapbox now for a little bit. I'm sorry. That's just, I feel strongly about that kind of stuff.